the burden of malaria is massive. Nearly 40% of the world's population live in at risk of malaria. There are 207 million cases estimated to occur each year, and the parasite kills 600,000 people a year, predominantly young children in Africa.
The main concern about malaria is the emergence of resistance to the artemisinin derivative. Then this resistance is going to spread elsewhere in the world, and we know what will happen because it has happened in the past with other drugs, that when it reaches Africa, then you know millions of children would die.
We have seen over the years with malaria research and actually in control that it has to be addressed in a multidimensional way. And the model that WARN works with is a very good example of having people with different disciplines, different skills, and really coming from different institutions to work on a problem together.
So the WARN network is to date a group of 230 research institutions around the world working collectively and pooling their data to try to optimize the medicine that we are using against malaria.
To make an improvement in health that is applicable to everybody, then you have to take a holistic view of the problem. You have to identify all the bits and pieces that contribute to that problem.
WARN has collected more than two-thirds of all the ACT published data in the world. That represents more than 90,000 individual patient data, not only on clinical efficacy, but also on molecular markers, pharmacology, in vitro, and drug quality.
So working with WARN has supported my individual research, mainly through our collaborations with partners, particularly in Africa, who are looking at mechanisms of drug resistance and surveillance of drug resistance markers. And I think that the WARN network has provided an opportunity for training and engagement of this community, and also to allow this group of endemic scientists to bring their data into the WARN network and share that with a broader community.
Donc WARN a développé des outils, et ces différents outils donc nous pouvons les mettre en œuvre dans nos programmes de recherche. Donc vraiment nous avons pu bénéficier beaucoup de WARN.
The role that WARN has played in setting SOPs, standard operating procedures, in setting standards for data control, having the experts in the field really there to set the gold standards for data collection, data storage and managing, and then also setting standards for gatekeeping data, I think has been really important.
This should form the foundation for the evidence that people like the World Health Organization would need to create policies to advise on how to treat patients.
One of our focus now is to work with vulnerable groups, those who are the most affected and in danger by a malaria infection. And for instance, that small infants, malnourished children, co-infected patients with HIV, pregnant women.
We can help actually in the development of new drugs, for example, by collecting all the data from new clinical trials and try to assess if the new dosing regimen that are being developed are optimal.
We believe that the innovative and collaborative approach that we have developed with malaria can be beneficial for other research communities, and we are trying to look at how we can facilitate access to the tools that we have developed to other tropical neglected diseases.
There's a hope that we could even eliminate malaria, but it's a formidable challenge.
We are looking at a long-term strategy here, and we believe strongly that there's only a collaborative approach that can achieve that. It's not going to be one game and one player. It has to be a group of individuals going in the same direction for the same objective.